We are just getting the latest COVID-19 numbers now. Four new cases have been reported in Ontario this hour. That includes a man in his 70s who died in Simcoe County earlier today. Now, while it may appear that the number of new cases in Ontario is slowing down, public health officials say it doesn't mean there is a downward trend in this province. In fact, there are hundreds of cases still under investigation, and we have heard story after story of people who say they are showing symptoms and have been turned away from assessment centres.
We're shutting down the whole country, but yet we don't have tests to figure out where it's coming from. So it's just kind of frustrating.
Our City News inbox has been flooded with the same issue. People in the province who say they want to be tested but have to wait days for answers. And today, Ontario's public health officials said they are short on swab kits, trying to purchase more.
That has been a challenge because there's been large global demand.
Most of the kits are apparently made in northern Italy, but officials say they are confident they will soon have more. They're also working to ramp up staff at assessment centres. But we've heard from a number of potential patients who say they've been turned away.
We are working on with Public Health Ontario to develop some clearer prioritization criteria. They should not be turning away people who are under 60.
92% of cases in Ontario are related to travel outside Canada, and of that, 29% travel to the U.S. Officials say the Public Health Ontario lab has made modifications, now able to test up to 2,000 samples a day. The goal is to eventually get to 5,000. Nationwide, 37,000 tests have been conducted so far. Federal health officials, along with the World Health Organization, have stressed just how important it is to test as many people as possible.
This allows us to identify cases quickly and interrupt any chains of transmission and slow the spread of COVID-19.
And what makes a lack of tests even more concerning is the new reality that there is community spread in this province. Three cases were reported yesterday that have no links to travel outside Canada.
There's some cases out there, two or three or a few number, not a high percentage as Dr. Yaffe has alluded to, that they don't know actually where they got it from. We're doing all that parallel testing.
Frontline workers say physicians are already being more restrictive in testing, reserving them for critically ill patients.
Many of our hospitals are already starting to run low on supplies of swabs for testing.
There are currently 1,500 cases under investigation, and 9,500 tests have come back negative here in Ontario.